Hello friends, today we are studying about how to about OpenCV. So today we are covering this topic. First is introduction of OpenCV, and the second how to build and configuration the library of OpenCV in our system, and the last one is the implementation of OpenCV in Python. So firstly I introduce OpenCV. So basically OpenCV stands for open source computer vision. That is a library of programming function, and it's mainly aimed at real time computer vision originally, and it originally developed by Intel. And OpenCV supports a wide variety of programming languages such as C++, Python, Java, and it's also available on different platforms that including Windows, Linux, Android, and iOS. And its interface for high-speed GPU operation based on CUDA and OpenCL are also under active development. And this library is used for under the open source BSD license. And so the next topic is installation of OpenCV in our system. If we want to OpenCV library in our system, then we use sudo apt get install lib opencv dev python opencv. And if we want to in Python IDE, then we use this command. After installation of OpenCV in our system, then we are use OpenCV library in Python by using this keyword cv2, and we have use various function to show image in a window, to read image, to write image. So firstly we use a cv2 im read image to read an image, the image should be in the working directory, or a full path of image should be given. And the second argument is the flag which specify the way image should be read. So we have a different ways to show image. Like if we want to show image in color image, then we use cv2.imreadColor. And if we want to load image in grayscale mode, then we use cv2imreadGrayscale. And if we want to show the image in alpha channel, then we use cv2imreadUnchanged. So then after that we use imshow method to display an image in a window, and the window it automatically fits to the image size. And the first argument is window name, which is string, and the second argument is our image. So we can create as many windows as we wish, but with different window names. And then we use a wait key and destroy all window. So wait key is a keyboard binding function, and its argument is a time in milliseconds, and the function wait for specific milliseconds for any keyboard event. And if we press any key in that time, then the program continues. Otherwise, it passes zero, and it waits indefinitely for a keystroke that can also be set to detect specific keystroke like. So key is pressed, and which will be discussed below. And then we also destroy all window, and this function used to destroy all windows that we have created. And if we want to destroy any specific window that by using this function, where we pass the exact window name as the argument, then and we also use this function that is named window. So we this is a special case where we already create a window and a load image to it later. And in that case, we can specify whether window is resizable or not. And by default, its flag is CV2 window auto size. But if we want to specify flag to be CV2 window normal, that use to resize window. And that will be helpful when image is too large in dimension and adding track by bar to windows. So now I run this code. And how to and show how to display an image in window. See, here we display an image in window, and we can also write an image By using this method, I am write. And the first argument is here we are specify the path where we want to write the image, and the second is our image. And here we are write an image. See, so thank you friends for watching this video.